Hello, everybody. It's the Poltergust 5000. Kirby Triple Deluxe. Oh my gosh. Never mind. What was that? Like, I was like, like, what are you doing? Okay, let me quickly delete Let me quickly delete this file that I started up. Just only the first. Yes, I want to delete the file. Jeez, you gotta ask me three times. That's good gravy. Okay. Triple Deluxe. Let's go. If you don't stop burping. Jeez. Okay. Let's watch the opening cutscene. I know Chuggaaconroy just did his LP of this, but considering my birthday is coming up, I wanted something that was significant to me, and this game kind of popped into my head, and I was like, you know what? I should do that. So here I am. I know I haven't really done a proper LP of Return to Dreamland yet, but I figure if anybody really wants to know the plot, the lore behind the, well, not that we explained it much, but you can go watch, but I do have that co-op with the Witch King 002. And, yeah. So I will eventually get around to doing Return to Dreamland, but for now I want to do this. I'm recording this ahead. It is currently April 1st, actually. I want to try and get part 7 of wow, I kind of lost track of time. I might have to skip out on Super Smash Bros. Melee and start uploading on Sundays if I want to get part 7 of this up on my birthday, which is April 11th, by the way. People who know me will probably... Actually, well, hell, that would be part 6, wouldn't it? Well, I should probably cliffhang it before... yeah, because this game only has 6 worlds. I'm totally not even watching the cutscene. Yeah, this game only has 6 worlds. I forgot that it only had 6 worlds. Both the 3DS ones only have 6 worlds. It's amazing that they have that the 3DS ones both only have 6 worlds, and it's still more than Star Allies had. Star Allies was, man, that game was short. Oh, who's this mysterious gentleman? Man, this music is awesome. Man, DDD looks so weird in this game. He's like so. I don't know, he looks like a toy. He looks like he came out of the Link's Awakening remake. Oh no! Man, Kirby's so shocked. You don't see those like perfectly circular spooked Kirby eyes very often outside of like Kirby 64. It's pretty much the only other time you ever really see them a lot. But you see him in this. Looks really funny. Oh boy. Okay, that's the end of the cutscene. We're done now. We're done. I'll go. All right, here we are. Oh, I love this map theme. The green's done with this like super soft whistling. I like that banner behind the world name. World 1, Fine Fields. I hate when games call the worlds levels and call the level something different. It's like, dude, can't we just decide on a consistent terminology for this shit? So here we are in the first level. Ooh, it's so pretty. Man, this really is beautiful. Look at this. Like, can you imagine a more beautiful fucking heavenly starting screen? Don't taint this experience by singing your dump lyrics. Not your dump lyrics. Yeah, like you're the one that came up with those. Anyway. This is running pretty smoothly so far. You'll have to excuse if there are little bits of hiccuping in the frame rate throughout this LP. I have this game on 3DS, but I decided to record it on Citra because Citra supports higher resolutions. You might be able to tell that the game itself is not in 240p like it normally would be natively. I'm recording this at, well, it's not quite 720p. Because my monitor isn't big enough, what I should do is I should switch monitors. Because I'm recording this on my lesser monitor, my smaller monitor. Because the switch is hooked up to the other one. I can never remember if those guys are Sword Knights or Blade Knights. I think they're Blade Knights. Ooh, Beam. I like Beam. Oh, he died. Oh well, that's too bad. Oh man, I love these modern Kirby games where you can basically just take an ability and just run with it, you know? I mean, I think there's really something to be said for the for like the classic, the more classic style of Kirby gameplay, where I really hope you can hear me. Yeah, it looks fine. Yeah, it looks like you should be able to hear me. I should really be recording my commentary separately. Ah! Okay. I think there's definitely something to be said for the classic Kirby games that only had, where each ability only had one thing that it could do, you know? For, you know, having a more tight design that isn't as susceptible, you know, you couldn't really main any one ability in the previous Kirby games, and that's part of what made the copy ability feel more special in those games, was that you actually had to make use of the fact that there were multiple abilities. But in this game, it's like, well, hell. I should have picked up that fire, huh? I don't think there's anything too... Oh, jeez. Oh, jeez. I guess I could explain why that's happening. Because I know 100% why it's lagging. The reason it's lagging is because of how Citra interacts with the RAM. Because the 3DS is a... Because, okay, so I have a pretty beefy computer, you know? Not to brag. I don't think it's really anything worth bragging over, but I have a pretty good computer. The problem is that, well, usually this isn't a problem, but my processor is a 6-core processor, which I think basically means that, the processor is made up of 6 smaller processors that are all working in tandem, working simultaneously for maximum efficiency. So, like, the processing power of my processor is the total amount of processing power that you get when you add all of those 6 cores together. And... Ooh, hey, a pep brew. Now, the problem is that the 3DS, and I think most game consoles only run on a single core processor. They're not designed to be able to deal with multiple processors, processing units, etc. And 3DS emulation is new enough that that nobody has come along and figured out how to program multi-core threading for Citra yet. So basically, Citra is currently running off of about 1/6 of my computer's power, which is which is, you know, not the worst thing in the world, because it basically means that recording in OBS makes absolutely no difference to the performance of the game, but, you know, obviously it's not running perfectly here. The power of the sun lies within. Find as many as you can and open up the pathway to the boss. Yeah, the sunstones. You remember in Return to Dreamland you picked up... Stop hiccuping! Jeez! In Return to Dreamland, you pick up the energy spheres, the ship parts, whatever you want to call. I know the ship parts are like, well, I always just call them gears. Because energy sphere is like the most boring possible name you could give them. But this game has sunstones instead. But instead of just being purely optional, like the energy spheres in Return to Dreamland, you actually have to collect a certain amount to access the boss level. Basically like the green stars in Super Mario 3D World. If you don't have enough, you can't get to the boss. And if you get all of them, you unlock the world's extra level, which is a mini gauntlet level that makes use of a bunch of classic Kirby tunes, which is one of my absolute favorite things about this game and Planet Robobot, is those extra stages that all use that are basically just an excuse for the game to revel in classic Kirby soundtracks. I wish more games did stuff like that, you know? I really wish more games did stuff like that. I wish more games would do that. Make, like, literally rip, like, songs from their classic games from all over their classic catalog, you know? Because, like, Mario does it sometimes, but when Mario does it, it's almost always just like, oh, it's the Super Mario Bros. Overworld theme, again! You know, but Kirby games, like the modern Kirby games, well, Triple Deluxe, Planet Robobot, I think Star Allies also had a little bit of it. I really love what they do, where in the bonus levels, they just, like, it's just a smorgasbord, it's a fucking buffet. Hi-ya! Dang it. He's gonna go up top now, isn't he? Yeah. Can I actually hit him? Boom! Yes, I can. I wasn't sure if that would work. Yeah, just using like classic tunes to score a new level. It's like, I don't know why more people don't do that. I guess it's because, like, for Kirby, it's basically been the exact same composers doing all the music since the very beginning of the series with the singular exception of Kirby's Dream Land 2. That's like the only game in the whole series that wasn't composed by like either Hirokazu Ando or Junichi Kawa, or there's like one more. Axe Knight, we got the Star Rod. Every level in the game has one golden keychain like that, and my advice to you would be to not move on to a new level until you have it, because there is not a single thing in the game that communicates to you where any golden keychains that you're missing are. There's nothing in the game, as far as I'm aware, that tells you whether or not you've gotten a golden keychain in a level, or, you know, where you're, or like where the missing golden keychains you haven't collected, what levels they might be in. Robobot fixed that. The golden stickers, if you viewed the ones you hadn't collected, it would give you a hint. It would basically just tell you what level they were in. But this game doesn't do that, I don't think. Oh, I love this music. This song is called The Cave in the Sky. Stop lagging! Jeez! This is Bell. This is one of the new abilities, the four new copy abilities they added in this game. And it's really fun. I wish they would bring this ability back. This is a really cool ability. Like, Bell is just a really cool aesthetic that you don't really see get played up very often in games. Oh, I gotta bust out my mouse here to do the tilt controls, because you're gonna hop into this, and I have to use my mouse to do this. To tilt to the side and put out this fire. Oh god, this song. You wouldn't believe it, but this song actually makes me kind of emotional. For reasons that are like, that will become apparent much later. I want to stick with Belle. Belle is fun. This is my... those are my LNRs. Does ZL and ZR do anything in this game? I guess not. You know, I guess not. Personally, I kind of like the other one. Oh, so what a great song. This is one of those soundtracks that were like most of the... Oh shit, there's a special thing back there. Oh, they actually appear. Okay. So you can break this wall open here, you can tell because it's cracked. Get out of here. Excuse me. Get out of here. What are those things called? Are those drips? Drippies? Maybe? I don't know. I don't remember what those things are called. Hey, I don't have my mic offset on, do I? No. Okay, good. Okay. Had to be sure. Ow. Was that the first one I'm taking damage? I think it might have been. Getting hit by that caboo. Like, what the heck? We're not playing Bug Fables. Get that out of here. That would be a cool... Man, that would be a cool theme for a Kirby game. Oh, I gotta do this again. Alright, can I just... Oh, I have to hit A while I'm doing this? Gee, that's awkward. I have to use the mouse, and then I have to hit A while I'm still holding the mouse. Oh, shoot. Oh man, this is gonna take some getting used to. Okay, obviously you can see the sunstone right there. Yeah, those tilt things, those are gonna be a bit of an issue going forward. Because, I also gotta keep an eye. I also gotta keep a lookout for those golden keychains, let's not forget. Can't have that. We can't have that? What? gives. All right, let's get Whip. Whip is a fun ability. I don't think Whip was in Planet Robobot, was it? Maybe it was. Well, weren't there like Haltman goons that had whips? Maybe I'm imagining things. Oh god, it's the puzzle music. Oh god, no, why? Okay, I forget exactly what you're supposed to do here. Wait, no! Stop! Okay. I wasn't sure exactly. Oh, what does it do here? Oh, come on, go down there. Yeah, what I was saying before. Dude, get your cursor off the screen. Jeez. I should really make that not visible, because I'm gonna have to be putting my cursor up on screen to tilt stuff. That's not the golden keychain? Running out of time! I must find that golden keychain! Of course, the thing is, now that I... Like, the first time I played the game, I didn't know that I would have to... That it was optimal. Yeah, but then you give me an item, I don't care. Fire. I like fire in this game. Because the fireball move, you have, like, a lot more momentum coming out of it, so you can chain it together a lot easier and, like, skip and, like, just fly over huge swaths of terrain. What is this? Is this Hornhead? No, it's Mr. Flosty! Oh, no! It takes the medicine 2.5 hours to get to the ulcer. Oh, no! Man, quit lagging. Jeez. What is it about my Kirby LPs and being cursed with lag? Like, remember I did that Squeak Squad? Don't even think- I'm getting this golden keychain. Don't think I was gonna miss that. Da-da-da-da! Alright. Yaw! Man! Urg. If you get number one, you actually get another keychain for it. It's not a special keychain, but you need to get all the keychains you can if you want to get 100%. Which I have done that. Superstar Ultra Koozer. Those crazy guys. Uru from Mass Attack. That's like the one Kirby game I really haven't played. Other than those all those really weird minigame spin-offs. Cooking! What is this? Dynablade! Hoo-ah! Not a hoo-ah. Ew! Man, Kirby sounds like such a baby in this game. Like, he already sounded like young, but in this game, like, oh, like in Return to Dreamland, he at least had some semblance of maturity. But in this game, like when you beat a level and he goes, ew! He like literally sounds like an infant. Oh man, this crazy music! This music actually wasn't on my first time I downloaded the OST to this game. It didn't have this song on it. Oh jeez, why would you launch that way? Nah, I'm gonna eat this cherry. Cherry motherfucker. Oh, quit, dude. You seriously gotta stop lagging, dude. You're about ready to piss me off. Oh, it's a Gorilla D. Man, it's funny because this game I think actually. Well, actually, this game came out before then. Did this game come out before or after the Game Grumps Kirby's Epic Yarn series, where Dan keeps calling the Waddle Dees monkeys, and Aaron like gets increasingly more annoyed every time he asks the question? He's like, Daniel, it's a Waddle Ding Dong. Oh, a red star? Is that the best you can give me, man? I almost died there. That would have been embarrassing. Me? The Poltergust 5000 dying in Kirby Triple Deluxe? Me, the Poltergust 5000 dying at all in a modern Kirby game? Well, maybe in the true arena. Lord knows it took me a while to beat Soul Melter EX. Holy crap. That might be the hardest thing I've ever had to do in a Kirby game. I think the song is called, like, Fine Fields 3 Prairie Area. Man, quit making me use the tilt. Jeez, what a pain in the ass. Boom, bitch. Alright. Oh, now we got three boom bitches. Alright, let's... You want to try and nestle them into the corners here so that they're explosive radius? can cross as much terrain as possible. That should do some damage. Get fucked, Bronto Burt! Oh god, the pain! How the hell is that Waddle Dee still alive? Dude, please dash. I think this was also the first game. This was the first Kirby game to have, like, dash, to have, like, smash dashing, like, in Super Smash Bros. Yeah, because I think this was the first Kirby game to actually be playable with anything resembling a control stick, other than, like, Kirby Air Ride. Even Kirby 64 on the Nintendo 64, that was one of the few games on the N64 that actually used the D-pad for movement. Oh, I gotta be fast here. I'm sure at least one of these things. Eeh. Jeez, man. Holy crap! Ow.
The pain, oh, it hurts so badly.
What's in here? We can hear that sad, oh no, not the puzzle music. Oh god, not the wall, no. Oh man, oh, this is gonna be a huge pain. Okay, I need to light the fuse, and then you tilt the 3DS to, like, hold this thing in place. And then you move it underneath that thing, and then you get into the- Oh! I forgot to get in the can on. That's embarrassing. Okay, get into position. Stay on target. Stay on freaking target! It doesn't need to be lined up perfectly. But you need to be pretty close. Yeah, like that's enough. Get your cursor off the screen! Okay. Oh! Man, look at those Bronto Burts just chilling in the- Oh no, they're coming after me. Okay. I was gonna say, look at those Bronto Burts just chilling in the background. What a cool touch. And then they try to swoop in at me. What the fuck, man? Oh great, we got another fruit. Y'all ready to turn into set piece Kirby for a bit here? I didn't even mention it the first time. I was too busy talking about crap. But yeah, this is the gimmick of this game, is Hypernova Kirby. Basically this game's answer to super abilities. I still cannot believe this isn't Kirby's Final Smash and Ultimate. Like, no, like you know, it was right here. Huh? You know, it was right here. They had this ability right here, this upgrade of Kirby's most signature move with an impressive aesthetic and bombastic abilities, but no. They just gave him a freaking Triforce Slash clone. You know? Like, jeez. I'm not gonna lie, these are probably my least favorite parts of the game, just because they have, like, zero replay value. Because you basically just... You know, when you have an ability as overpowered as Hypernova, the only possible puzzle they can come up with is do it now, don't do it now. So it's basically just, there is so much goddamn waiting, you know. Man, this game makes good use of leitmotif. That's the reason why that puzzle music makes me emotional, is because of the leitmotif and what I associate with it. Yeah, because I bring reusable bags when I go to the grocery. Okay, here, you have this iron ball, like in the first stage, but we don't have enough room to make it go far enough to get enough swinging power. So you gotta pull these iron blocks out here and then pull it back. Man, if only wrecking balls, you know, lit up helpfully to indicate when they were high enough up that they would be able to generate enough destructive force to destroy something. Wow, what a fucking labyrinth of a sentence that was. That turned out to be. I'm afraid of, like, when I'm gonna miss my first gold keychain, because there's really nothing you can do when you miss one other than replay the whole stage. And you know, unlike missing a single sunstone, there's no way you can, like. Unlike when you miss a single sunstone, there's no way you can be like. Oh, jeez! Holy crap. Unlike when you miss a sunstone, there's no way, there's no indication of where it is in the level. You just know that it's in the level somewhere. It could be up here in the, it could be up here in the trough, for all I know. Ooh, I love this area. Look how nice and dark this is. How cucka feeling inducing. Oh, it's not even real. Because now we're gonna peel it all away. Because everybody knows that Overcast is evil. Everybody knows that only evil people like dark days. I bet it's down here. Oh god, I didn't find it, man! Is it down here? No! Ugh, oh, I didn't get the gold keychain! Ah! Shit! Okay, maybe I did and I just didn't see it. Yeah, there you go, that's more like it.
I didn't find it! I got a card I wanted!
Man. Well, that's gonna happen sometimes. Oh, no, I did! Okay, never mind! Jeez. Triple Star! Kirby Mouse Attack. Is this not an American ROM? Weird. Biospark! Why the hell isn't Biospark in this game? Biospark was in, Yeah, Biospark is in Star Allies, right? They brought back Biospark because Moonja is just lame. Mirror Kirby. Do you remember in Super Smash Bros. In the game the mirror ability? Yeah, dude, it's like... Dude. Kirby has two iconic abilities. Suck and Bee! Okay. Alright, next! Next! Oh, we got a Yogurt Yard remix. Fucking Yogurt Yard. Oh yeah! Okay, so Spark in this game, much like in Return to Dreamland, it works as a combination of Spark and Plasma from Superstar, where you can build up static by mashing the directions and then release a mega thing. The thing is, is that the technique of guard and then mash doesn't work as well in this game, because this was the first game to introduce... Man, that hat looks really cool. Nice and polygonal. Because this game was the first Kirby game, I believe... I don't think Return to Dreamland had this. Maybe it did. I think this was the first game to have basically what amounts to roll dodges and sidestep dodges that you can use by, you know, doing directional inputs while you're guarding. And that, and let me tell you, that comes in handy. Okay, Hornhead is our first. Hornhead is also a new ability, and it's a really awesome ability too. Get out of here. This is Beetle ability! Fire Kirby! No, it's Beetle Kirby! And Beetle Kirby is one of those abilities that has a unique flying thing, which is very satisfying. Reminds me of Terraria. It's got some really cool moves, it's really strong, it's fast. Beetle Kirby rocks. I'll probably be using Beetle Kirby against the regular arena when we get to that point, but I'll definitely have to use Hammer Kirby for the true arena. Because holy crap, this game might have one of the harder true arenas. I think this game's true arena is harder than, I don't know if it's harder than Return to Dreamland. Return to Dreamland had a pretty tough true arena, but this one's really hard because the last boss, in phase one, it's really easy to lose your ability because there's pits everywhere. Not to mention, you know, easy to get one-shotted because there's pits everywhere, you know. Man, you jump high in this game. You'll notice that if you play the different Kirby games. I think Kirby Planet Robobot actually has, like, slightly higher gravity, which you wouldn't think, considering how many assets they reuse from Kirby game to Kirby game throughout these days. You wouldn't think that there would be anything that, you know, differed in the engines, but I swear it's true. I swear the Planet Robobot has higher gravity, has stronger gravity than this game. Like, I can't just be imagining things. Like, you know what I should do? Is I should compare the jump arcs. I should get a plan. Do I have a Planet Robobot ROM on here? I don't know if I do, actually. Oh man, it's you guys! Man, remember you guys? Were these guys in, Return to Dreamland? I forget if they were in Return to Dreamland. The fucking Kirby 64 spike enemies. Oh, we knock it off. I remember when this game first came out, it drove me nuts that they didn't, that Bugsy wasn't the Beetle mini-boss, but then again, you know, Bugsy isn't even the right kind of Beetle. Bugsy is like a stag beetle, and Beetle Kirby is based on a rhinoceros beetle, so it wouldn't have worked anyway. How do I get in there? Am I gonna go through like the? This must be like one of those areas in Amazing Mirror where like eventually you come back through the other way. You know what I mean? Yeah, it's definitely not down there. Woohoo! Oh god, I love Beetle Kirby. It's just so much fun. Ow! Man, I hate those guys when they just spawn in midair, already going up, and like they jumped before they, This is pretty tricky. This is gonna be trickier than it normally would be, because I don't have 3D to tell where the Gordos are. You can look at the shadows. That's pretty much the best you got. Ooh, hey, an invincibility candy. That's our first one. And boy, you move fast with these things in this game. Holy crap, y'all are cock-a-boo-boo. Woohoo! Ah. Oh, great, we gotta tilt again. Is so nerve-wracking, because I still don't fully understand the mechanics of this, like, touch tilt that Citra has going on. Like, sometimes it seems like it continues even after, yeah, like, right there, like, I don't know why I didn't stop there. I didn't think I was moving that far in either direction, but it just kept, you know, back and forth like a crazy fool. What the hell? I can't hit that note for shit. Be careful here. We got a barbecue. Like a sauna. Like a barbecue. Like someone having a barbecue. Yeah, like right there. It actually maintained the tilt when I jumped from that one to the other one. I guess I could hit reset tilt. You know, that would be an option. Dishwasher? Yes. I'm actually happy with how well this is running. I know it looks laggy sometimes, but well. Listen, I could have if I tried to record this off my 3DS, it would have been a lot worse. Also, I probably wouldn't have been able to do it at all. So it was either this or like wait 5 years for somebody to finally take it upon themselves to figure out how to do Citra multi-core. Why are you giving me a thing? You gonna give me a pep? Oh, no, you're an enemy. I thought, for some reason, I thought that was Bandana D coming to, but I actually want Belle. Yeah. Ba-ba-ba-ba! Ooh, that's a 7, I reckon. Or a 1, actually. Not a 7, it's a 1. 1, 1, 1, 1! What do we got? Plasma Wisp, cool beans. Dark matter, violent dark matter in World 1, that's weird. Birdon. We got Uwadeluzoi. And Gip. Alright. Sweet. Hi! Yeah, something tells me we have 5 sunstones. We have how many do we have actually? How many were there in this world? The sunstones you found open the boss stage! And they've also opened the extra stage, which I don't know. Oh god, I don't know what. What am I gonna do those? What time am I up to anyway? 34 minutes! Holy jeez, man! Find 12 sunstones. You've unlocked an extra stage. Should I do that after the boss? Oh, man. I don't know. I don't know when to do the extra stage. I think I'll do it after the boss. Well, you know what, actually? What if I just ended this episode here? Before the first boss. Yeah, you know what? I think I like that idea. So I'm going to end this first episode here before the first boss. I was originally planning on doing one, do one world in every video. But I don't think that's going to be quite as important. I think if it ends up taking me, like, 8 episodes to do this, I'll still be able to get the final boss on my birthday, which is what really matters to me. So, yeah. Bye, and I'll see you next time. Ba-ba-da-ba, ba-ba-da. Oh, I should have whistled it.